Welcome back to another episode of Shipping Tips. My name's Eric, and in this video, we're going to be shipping a Nintendo Wii, but you already knew that from the thumbnail and the title of this video. In the Shipping Tips series, I go over shipping-specific items or just tips in general. I do have a link to the playlist in the description where you can watch other episodes of Shipping Tips. And this series is geared towards beginners and intermediate eBay sellers. And there's not only one way to ship an item. I'm just highlighting one way, the way that I'm doing it the day that I'm filming the video. So with that disclaimer, thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't already, please give the video a thumbs up. If you aren't already subscribed to the channel, consider subscribing. And let's get into the shipping tips for this Nintendo Wii. I've shipped a fair amount of Wiis in my day. A lot of the times I will use priority mail boxes because Wiis are very small and they fit in a variety of priority boxes. This is the 1095. It goes great for a cubic rate. It should be getting your Wii shipped for under $12 anywhere in the country. And if you don't have this box, you can also use the medium flat rate box, perfectly fine for the Nintendo Wii. However, in this case, my Nintendo Wii sold to somebody in Quartzsite, Arizona, that doesn't have a P.O. box. And if you're familiar with Quartzsite, it's a lot of RVs, temporary housing, and the specific address that I have is non-deliverable by USPS. So I'm going to be shipping it UPS and I'm going to put a signature confirmation on it because these communities are a little bit complicated and I want to make sure that I have proof of delivery and it doesn't get stolen off of somebody's temporary RV porch. And because I'm shipping it UPS, I'm not shipping it in this priority mailbox. I just wanted to show it for demonstrational purposes because I have done it before and it's a great way to ship your Nintendo Wiis. So we are gonna be shipping over here. We're gonna be recycling this FabFitFun box and shipping this United Parcel Service, UPS. The guy's wearing short shorts and the brown uniforms. And for reference, this box is 14 by 9.5 by 5.5. Essentially what we're gonna do is we're gonna bubble wrap the Wii, we're gonna bubble wrap individual parts, and then we're going to place them in the box, remove all space for anything to shift around with either more bubble wrap or some other void filler dunnage. And then we're gonna measure it, weigh it, and buy UPS postage through Amazon, the platform that it's sold on, where I'm probably going to get my best rate. I'm gonna be using this half inch bubble wrap, just going to place the Wii in it, and I'm going to use a perforated section because it's about the width of the Wii. And I'm just going to put it in, bubbles facing the product because they fill in gaps and they just hug the product better. When you do it like that, I'm just gonna roll it a couple times, and then I'm gonna put a piece of tape on that bubble wrap. I'm gonna take another piece, hit it like that, so I bubble wrap the corners, and then I'm gonna start building our box of components. I'm not gonna bubble wrap the charger. This is a very hardy piece of equipment. And I'm just going to slide that into the box right there. I will bubble wrap these together. Because it's looking kind of tight in here, I'm going to use a smaller size bubble wrap. And then I'm going to start by rolling the Wiimote. And then I'm going to add the sensor. And then I'm going to add the nunchuck. Now it's a nice bubble wrapped one piece component. And I can put that onto the side right here. So we still have a little bit of empty space right here. I'm just gonna put the games like that. Just going to take a piece of craft paper, use that as our void fill right there. We're gonna weigh the package and it's 5 pounds, 2 ounces. I already got the measurements from before. I'm gonna plug that in to Amazon. So we got our dimensions, our weight in there. UPS is $15 with the signature confirmation. Brings it to $20.51. Usually I can get the Wiis shipped a lot cheaper than that with USPS, but for this instance, I have to use UPS because of the address, and I wanna use signature confirmation for my own risk tolerance. I'm gonna hit buy shipping. We're gonna hit print shipping. We're gonna get our shipping label. I also got the Amazon invoice that I'm going to include in that package. And then last but not least, I'm gonna add a couple of bands of tape just to secure. Then we're gonna take our label. I like to stick the label on the side because more than likely things will be stacked on top of this and it just would make it easier in my mind for them to scan it if it's on the side rather than being on the top where another package might be on it. And of course you're not gonna wanna put it on the bottom because then it's just, they gotta flip it over to scan it. So I feel like the side is the best placement for the label, but that's just my opinion. Don't really have any science to back that up. So now I'm gonna take this and just drop it off at the UPS store down the street. You don't have to wait in line. You can just tell them it's a pre-labeled package and you should just be able to hand it to them, get a receipt if you want, or just be on your way. The worst way to ship this would be to stand in line at a UPS, have them pack it, have them ship it. It would be the most expensive. It would take you the most time. Ideally, I would have wanted to ship this USPS to save on the cost. It probably would have got it down to about $12 or $13. As I said before, this address kind of forced me to use UPS, and it happens like that sometimes. If you are not shipping a Wii on a platform, you're just shipping it to like a friend or family member, then you could go to a post office, get a free flat rate box, buy postage through Pirate Ship or Shippo. I'll put links to those in the description. It would save you a lot of time and it would save you some money from paying retail and having to wait in line at the post office as well. So thank you guys so much for watching. I tend to use recycled boxes, recycled material when I can, to each their own. There are multiple ways to do this. This is just one way highlighting how I was doing it today. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any other questions or you want to tell me how I did something wrong, throw them in the comment section and I will talk to you in the next video. Bye. Before somebody destroys me in the comments for not putting the AV cord in there, I did remember, I forgot to put the AV cord in there. So I'm gonna open it back up, put the cord in there, and then seal it back up and send it on its way. Sometimes that happens.